Good morning. Good morning and welcome. Today we celebrate the Mass for the fourth Sunday of Easter. Our procession this morning, we've come as far by faith. Please rise.
Thank you. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has made both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified." Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart. And they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, my brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is made to you and to your children, and to all those far off, whomever the Lord our God will call." He testified with many other arguments, and with exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted this message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day. The word of the Lord.
There is nothing I shall know.
this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in his footsteps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was insulted, he returned no insult. When he suffered, he did not threaten. Instead, he handed himself over to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body upon the cross, so that free from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds, you have been healed, for you have gone astray like sheep. But you now return to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Wander
And we should never forget that there are many wolves in this world. This world is a very violent place. And so for that reason, we need a shepherd. We need someone who will call us back from the edge, who will keep us safe, who would even lay down his life for us. And in Jesus, we have that good shepherd who is constantly watching over us. We may still make mistakes from time to time. We may get lost for a while. But if we always center our lives on Jesus, if we make him the focus of our lives, then any time we do wander off, get off on the wrong track, or so forth, we won't go too far before we find our way back to safety. And if we take too long, then Jesus, the Good Shepherd, will come in search of us. And this same article said that sheep and shepherds like to keep each other company, because when they're out in the fields for long periods of time, it can get pretty boring and lonely. So they hang out together. And as would be expected, all the sheep get mixed up. And clearly Jesus had some kind of background with shepherds, because he says it in today's gospel, when it comes time to separate the sheep, the shepherds call to them, and every sheep knows which voice to follow. They know who is calling them. And for us as Christians, there's only one voice that we should be listening to, and that's the voice of Jesus. In this world, there are so many other voices we could be following, and some of them are very attractive, but they lead us the wrong way, into dishonesty, selfish behavior, or violence, or addiction. And we have politicians sometimes who love to play on our fears in order to get us to go and follow them rather than following what Jesus teaches us in the gospel. And that's why we need to pray, read the Bible, go to Mass, so we can never lose track of what our shepherd's voice sounds like. If we read the gospel every day, you know, Jesus' voice sort of sinks in, and we're able to hear him. When we listen to these other voices that are confusing, we won't be lost if we learn to recognize his voice. And most important, we really need to be together in order to learn how to listen to Jesus. That's why we stick together, because it's together we hear the voice of Jesus most clearly. You know, there have been people in this community who told me that they stopped going to Mass for a while, and somebody else in the community reached out to them and said, "Hey, we miss you. Why don't you come back?" And that's how the Good Shepherd works in the world today. He reaches out to others through us. It's we together who carry out the mission of the Good Shepherd, and we all have a role to play in that. And this is also World Day to pray for vocations. So today we pray for vocations to priesthood, to consecrated life, to the permanent diaconate, all the different forms of lay ministry. We have quite a few parishioners here in this parish who have gone through the 3-year lay formation program. Well, the parish certainly reaps the benefits of that. We pray for all of these people. We pray for an increase in vocations because we need leaders, you know, and we are all called to lead one way or another. We also pray for vocations. And there's also something I need to share with you. I sent out an email yesterday afternoon, so perhaps you saw the email. But it's with a heavy heart that I share with you that this summer I'm going to be transferred. And it's not about going to a new assignment that gives me a heavy heart, but of course, it's not being a weekly or daily part of this community that I've come to love so much. I love Saints Teresa and Bridget. I love all of you. I love every minute I've been with you. But just to briefly explain what's going on in case you didn't get the email. In Archbishop Rosansky, we have a good shepherd, and he's very concerned about the pastoral care of everybody in the archdiocese. He makes that his top priority. And so what he wants is for the leadership of the archdiocese to be in closer contact with everyone, you know, so that decisions get made a little bit more consultative, you know, the way Pope Francis calls us in synodality. And right now, pretty much all of the administration is centered at the Regali Center, which is archdiocesan headquarters. So what Archbishop Rosansky is doing is he's dividing the archdiocese into 3 vicariates, and each vicariate will be headed up by a priest who serves as episcopal vicar. And so I've been asked to be the episcopal vicar of what's called the Northern Vicariate. That is pretty much the city of St. Louis and the near suburbs. And for the most part, it's everything within 270. You know, and so I'll be working
that looks at pastoral care, social outreach, social justice issues, schools, all those different kinds of things. Because the whole idea is accessibility, that people shouldn't have to go to the Bugali Center in order to talk with somebody who's helping with the administration of the Archdiocese. I was able to say yes to this largely because of the 3 years I've spent here. You know, and coming here got me excited about the gospel of Jesus all over again because of your zeal and the way you carry out the mission of Jesus every day. You know, that made it easier. It also made it easier that this parish is within the vicariate, so our paths will continue to cross. But I certainly ask for your prayers. This is nothing I ever expected to be doing. I don't know how to do it. It's going to be a learning curve. It's new for the Archdiocese as well. And of course, please know also that I'll continue to pray for you each day. I guess I should say one other thing. I'm going to be here until July 1st. Possibly even August 1st. So I probably should say that too.
Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And trusting in the love of the Good Shepherd, we offer our prayers and our petitions to him.
For the church, that we may always keep our eyes focused on Jesus, the Good Shepherd, and follow where he leads us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, turn our prayer.
For world peace, that nations may work together to support human dignity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, turn our prayer.
That as we move through all things new, we may find new ways to collaborate in serving the people of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick, that they may experience the tender care of the Good Shepherd, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they may enter the shepherd's gate into the eternal kingdom of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pause to call to mind the attentions we carry in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God and Jesus, you give us an example of a true shepherd. Help us to follow his example and to care for one another's needs. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands with praise and glory in his name, for our good and the good of all.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and never pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more. The Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers and the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Mitchell, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you in their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and to him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh,
Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for just a moment.
One is just a reminder of the back table. We left the pledge cards out for the annual Catholic appeal that supports so many of the charities in the Archdiocese. A lot of pledge cards have been coming in, so thank you very much for that. But you can still take yours on the back table or go to our website and give online. One thing that's helpful is if you write a check, make it out to the annual Catholic appeal rather than St. Teresa and Bridget. Also a reminder, May starts tomorrow. Third and the fourth week of May this year, we're going to have one Unity Mass. So third Sunday of May, 9:30 Mass. Fourth Sunday of May is Pentecost Sunday, and so we'll all be together for whatever the All Things New announcement is. So third and fourth Sunday we'll have Unity Mass. And then finally, I'm going to be gone this week. I had planned on being away this summer, but that's now impossible. So this is the only week to do it. So I'm leaving today and I'll be back Saturday. Although American Airlines keeps texting me these severe weather alerts, I don't know what's going to happen. Last time I ignored that, the plane almost crashed. People were screaming. Any visitors today?
Please stand and have a wonderful week.